You know the guy, Mehmet, who works for us? He was single for a long time, met this girl, Mary. He proposed to his girlfriend. He's getting married. And I was happy for the guy. But then I was told in the last staff meeting, Mehmet announced he's getting married on a day we do the radio show. I go, what? And he invited a whole bunch of people from the show to go. And of course, if they're working for me, they can go to Mehmet's wedding, but, you know, don't bother coming back. I mean, what are you kidding me? There's weekends, there's Thursdays, Fridays. Why would you get married on a day that I'm doing a radio show, one of the few days that you're needed? Why would you do that?
Well, there's lots of different things with like family and the day we wanted to do it and the time the place was available. So there were lots of things out of my control. And I apologize that it's during the week. Mm. I feel terrible about it. But and I don't want anyone to feel pressure if they don't want to come. I just wanted people to know that I wanted them included if they wanted to be there.
Man.
How do these things get out of his control? You know, he acts like he doesn't have anything to do with it.
Yeah, he acts like he's Prince Harry and the queen insists that we, what the fuck? You're so right.
No one's insisting anything.
I can't believe you're getting married, dude. You were pretty immature about all that.
Even the proposal is, everything is so damn stressful.
There's some trivia game that Mehmet plays with his fiance. Mehmet somehow managed to get the game to make the trivia question his proposal.
Asking this bonus question is guest HQ day, Mehmet.
Hi, Mary. Here's the big question. Will you marry me? Yes, no, or Denmark? And here's a free eraser.
Uh-oh. You better make up your mind, Mary.
I know the people you invited are upset because they're like, first of all, the whole shit they're saying is Mehmet had to know that the staff can't miss work and fly to his wedding. Evidently, it's in California. So the invite comes as a demand for money, basically. It's like, yeah, just send me some cash. Right. Everyone's all pissed off.
I understand. I invited more people from here than my own family. I've worked here like 8 years, this place.
So why would you get married without them?
Well, it's not just me getting married. It's two people with two lives. Yeah. And
well, you sit down with your wife. This is a pretty important discussion. And you go, listen, let's do it on a weekend. You know,
I hear you.
It's just weird.
It didn't work out that way. And if people can't come again,
how does it not work out that way though? I don't even understand. Like, what do you mean? The two of you are planning it. You act like it was done to you.
I'm one of the guys that's upset and I love Mehmet. I'm Mehmet. This isn't like a personal thing, but I got your invite in the mail and I was excited for everything. And then I noticed it was the destination wedding. And right away, my wife is like, well, you're going to that by yourself because I'm not getting on a plane and all this stuff with COVID. And I said, yeah, something I have to really think about. And I sat down at the computer to put it on the calendar. And it's like, it's a fucking Wednesday. It's like, what am I supposed to do? Like fly out after the show on Tuesday, halfway across the country, wake up at 3 a.m, wherever this is, do my job, and then go do a wedding on a Wednesday night and
he
come back
want you
and prep
there.
The show for the next day or for the next
Just
week.
Just send a gift. Just how much money would you want from Jason for your wedding?
Yeah, give me the number. 65 ahead, 150 ahead.
Oh, whatever you want to do. I understand.
Are you going to have kids?
There's no plan right now.
Good. He's got wacky ideas about how to raise children that are outright disturbing and he should never have children.
Well, since he doesn't make any of his own decisions, he'd better check to see if he's having children.
You got to hear this. I hope you're not serious about this. Mehmet would ensure his child would not grow up to be an obnoxious brat by raising him using fear and psychological torture. Here's Mehmet's idea of parenting.
What do you think your parenting philosophy would be?
I would just, you know, make sure my child is not an obnoxious brat and knows how to behave in public.
How would you?
The same way I was raised. Fear.
How do you do that? Fear?
Yes.
Do you believe in spanking a child?
If you psychologically torture them early enough, you can get in their head to where you don't have to raise a hand to them.
How do you psychologically torment them?
Well, you yell at them, make them scared of the world. You know, you make them feel insecure about themselves.
Jesus. You actually go against all the experts. The experts say, make a child feel safe and secure. Teach them how to fly on their own.
Well, Robin, you were in the Air Force. Think about our military. How do we train people in the military? You break them down until they're like nothing, and then you build them back up. And that's why we're the strongest fighting force in the world.
But you won't, your children won't have anything to break down. You will have broken them.
You forget the build them back up part of it. Oh, so you break them, then you build them.
I know what I'm going to get you for a wedding gift, a waterboarding kit for the kids.
Thank you.